So I normally wasn't going to cover Friday streams because Friday streams are usually too chill. They take a long time. They take a while to amp up, and the card itself is just like either a hit or a miss, right? And since it's Bermuda, you know, Bermuda is either a hit or a miss in the Western community. Either everyone hates it because it's like too broken, or it's too it caters to a different crowd, or otherwise, you know, you just love it because you are the different crowd, right? But so far, all the Bermuda cards have been really, really good. Not just effect-wise, because, of course, by now we do expect every single set that gets released for Standard basically sets a new standard for the metagame, right? And Bermuda, I think, is no exception. But so far, the effects that they've given to these cards are actually very interesting. They're not just, hey, yo, this is a fake stride, goes to a grade 4, yeah, just chill out. You get 3 force markers, you know, 3 force markers, just, that was like last month. But yeah, no, they're actually very interesting. They're kind of different. Some of them just get every single effect in the game. And this time we're seeing Olivia. And Olivia was a big G stride back in old Bermuda Triangle for G. And it's good to see that they kind of remade her in V, but also kind of made her more relevant and fit some, like, a niche that kind of they wanted to push, right? So here we have Olivia, a school, a toil, Olivia, on the Vanguard circle. When it attacks a Vanguard, choose up to 5 of your rear guards. If all of the chosen rearguards have different card names, stand all of them. And if you stand 3 or more rearguards, the shooting gets critical +1 until the end of battle. So, that's cool. Because just like the old effect, the old one was bounce. And if it was like different cards among them, you'd call. This is kind of the same thing, except it doesn't bounce, it stands. But this really goes well with another card that they released today. And that was the Reindeer reprint. So, this is the Reindeer reprint, and I really like how this card is designed because it actually just makes a lot of your old Highlander cards really, really good. And although, you know, this Reindeer, I don't know, it doesn't really look like the old Reindeer. It's like a nice, refreshing look, you know, nice, refreshing look. So, Velvet Voice Reindeer. So, continuous effect in the deck. When it would be revealed by a card's effect, it is regarded as a trigger unit instead of a normal unit. So, in Standard, if you play this, you can play 4 of her in your Highlander deck. And to make it more consistent, but if you reveal her by any of your top 10 checks, this counts as trigger, so it doesn't, you know, you don't fail the condition, which is really nice. It's really nice. And then the second effect is auto on Vanguard Circle. When it attacks, at the end of the battle that it attacked, you may discard 2 cards from your hand, reveal 10 cards from the top of your deck, and if all of the normal units revealed have different card names, write up to 1 of the revealed cards not named Velvet Voice Reindeer, so it can't write itself. Shuffle your deck, and that unit gets drive -1 till the end of the turn. At the end of this turn, put that unit on the bottom of your deck and ride a grade 3 card from your soul as rest. So, this is supporting Highlander with like a fake stride, but this fake stride is like a Luardi stride. So, Highlander's kind of like the new Luard, but there are actually some really, all the grade 4s, well, most of the grade 4s that were revealed, well, that were shown in the old sets, suddenly became way more relevant, right? So if you were to look at the top 4, you see a Laura, suddenly you just get a full field, and they all get +10k, and you just get, yeah, 5 attacks right there. But what else, right? If you ride an Inezka, you get 3 gift markers from that, so something 3, like 3 force markers, you get 3 force plus 3 more, like 1 more force, 1 more excel, and 1 more protect. That's like a big plus, right? It's a big plus, then excel 2 draws 1. And then you now have more spots to play with. That Laura that comes in, you know, again, if you get another Laura, bam. Sweet times. And then Olivia, of course. Olivia, you can just get the multi-attacks going, and it's pretty good. But, you know, when you start, if you start stacking Excel circles, right, you get 1 or 2, you have 4 in the front row, you can start standing things in the front row, and, like, it's really popping off, right? But then something like Perfect Performance Ange, right? They showed that on Tuesday, and we were kind of like, Ange, it seems very balanced, you know? It's not good enough. Well, not good enough, but, you know, it's just a very balanced card. But now with this card, with Reindeer, you can ride the Ange, and you get 4 Force Markers turns. So you're like a better Luard, in a way, right? So, I really like how this card is interacting, you know, with all the different cards in Bermuda. And there was also some other common cards that let you call like the top 2 cards from your deck. So yeah, no, it's definitely going somewhere. And I really like, yeah, just, I don't know what to say. Every single Bermuda card they've released so far has been really flavorful, at least given for their given niche that they're trying to fill. So yeah, keep an eye out for Bermuda. I think we'll probably test this tomorrow. And yeah, that should be fun. Should be fun. So go get those grade fours, right? If you are a Highlander fan and still have them, good stuff. But if you really want to get the Highlander, get them now. You only need one of them, unless you want to be really, really greedy and run like two copies of certain cards that you want. I don't know what to think of that. You'd have to test it and see how it goes and see if you're happy to miss sometimes in those crucial situations, or you want to play really consistent Highlander, which is kind of like a weird thing to say because consistency in Highlander. Yeah, so yeah, that's it for tonight. Only one card was revealed, but so far, every single card that they revealed has been really, really good on a Friday. So I'll catch you guys later. Bye.